Asian stocks struggled to stay calm on Thursday after Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen rattled U.S. banking stocks and the Fed, which raised rates by 25 basis points as expected, pushed back against rate cut bets this year. The weaker dollar, now in a five-day retreat, its longest losing streak since April 2021, is seen cushioning the blow to the region. Hong Kong and mainland shares are up, while Japan and Australia managed to temper losses. Philippine shares also closed lower as investors braced for the Banco Central's policy decision, which came out after trading hours. Security Bank's Dan Roses sees a one-and-done hike for the BSP, while the Fed gets 2 months to assess more data points.
I want to be able to assess it a bit more. It's not a contagion. Risk to financial stability remain manageable, but there are possibly some small cracks already emanating from the Fed rate hikes. So they'll be pausing to assess that. Fortunately, April is a non-central bank meeting month. So they'll have the benefit of 2 months of data.
The Banco Central eventually delivered a 25 basis point increase. For the day, the PSE index lost a fifth of 1% to close at 65.36. In corporate stories, PLDT saw its net income attributable to parent company more than halved to 10.5 billion pesos in 2022 as a big jump in expenses ate into the 6% growth in revenue. In fact, service revenues net of interconnection costs was even at an all-time high of 190 billion pesos, up 4%. Another silver lining, telco core income, which excludes the impact of asset sales and Voyager Innovations, reached 33.1 billion, up 10% year-on-year. Meanwhile, PLDT says its forensic review of the circumstances surrounding 48 billion pesos budget overrun last year is substantially complete and has identified no evidence of fraud, intentional concealment, or bad faith conduct on the part of any employee of the company and no basis to restate the company's historical financial statements. PLDT says it has also completed discussions with its major vendors, representing approximately 80% of its outstanding CapEx commitments as of December last year, and has entered into settlement and mutual release agreements with its major vendors in March 2023, reducing outstanding commitments to approximately 33 billion pesos. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.